Forgive me, Mr. Treasury Secretary Braggs.
As I said earlier, what we proposed to the G20 and what we spent some time discussing this morning was how to build a framework for cooperation that reduced the risks that future growth is imperiled by the re-emergence of large external imbalances, or that future financial stability is jeopardized by that. This is not something that is amenable to limits or targets. It's no reasonable person who understands economics could suggest that you could best achieve that objective by trying to impose quantitative limitations or targets. What we think makes sense, and I suspect there'll be broad support for this, is to set up a framework that gives you an early indication if the policies in place among the major economies in particular are likely to lead to the types of risks I described.
Mr. Geithner and Mr. Wang from China, the same question. So 2 weeks ago in Korea, G20 countries agreed on the
20国峰会马上就要召开了，我也预祝本次峰会能够取得圆满的成功。那么，作为这次峰会的前面的重要的一个基础性会议，G20财长和央行行长会议没有讨论具体的量化指标和形成共识。刚才我已经重复了，不论是20国财长会议还是今天的 APEC 财长会议，关于汇率问题，我们已经达成了共识。我相信，既然是共识，大家都会在这个框架内做进一步的研究和讨论。谢谢你。
And we've had this persisting problem of currency inflexibility, especially by China. But I think we're moving that ball down the field gradually.
Okay.